Hey guys.
Hey.
Hi Ingo. Hey Simon. Simon Fischer, our SVP of engineering. Great to have you here.
Hey Graham. Good to be in Cambridge.
Nice. Great.
Excellent.
Ingo, you know what time it is. Time for?
With Ingo.
5 minutes with Ingo.
So, you remember like 2 weeks ago we talked about cross-validation?
Yes. Yep.
We used those building blocks like representing data points or even here like groups of data. And we have seen how you can distribute data into training data and testing data,
yep.
Make a split, and then you build the model on the training data, and then you apply this model
sure.
on the testing data to make sure that you're never, well, applying the model on training data you already have been used, been using for training the model. So this leads to fair estimation. That's great. And Simon and I actually have been working on a cross-validation anyway in RapidMiner, so,
oh.
so we thought let's take this from here.
Oh, cool.
So here is an operator very quickly going in, and it's almost complete. You see, we built a decision tree here in this training phase,
yeah.
and then this is the second part of the data, so it's not the same part, it's a different part of data, and we now apply the model, and here, let's use this recommended operator down here, drag it in, and then connect it, and now the process is finished.
Okay.
So I can go up again,
yeah.
everything was good, and we can execute it now. All right, so that's the result.
Cool.
Yeah, exactly, so that's the result. What you see here is now the average over multiple of the iterations, 10 of the iterations in the cross-validation, the operator that Ingo just dragged in, the performance operator, measured the performance once, and here we see the average or the aggregate over all of the 10 iterations. And let's just look at a couple of those numbers here. So in the columns, what you see are the true values that are in the data, whereas on the rows, we have what RapidMiner predicted. So for instance, if we look at the middle center row here, there were 31 cases where the truth was iris versicolor and 4 where the truth was iris virginica. And in all of those cases in this row, RapidMiner predicted versicolor. So that means almost always was RapidMiner correct in 31 cases. And in 4 it was incorrect. So that's a total of 35 where RapidMiner said it's versicolor. And the ratio in which it was correct is here on the far right, that's 88.57%. And you get lots more insight here in the other rows for the other classes. And in the columns, you get the inverse. So there you get the ratio, the so-called recall. Mm. So the items that RapidMiner finds were iris versicolor would have been correct. Out of those 33, RapidMiner found 31.
So you see this basically for every single class, you see this recall for the three different classes, also the precision, how often it is correct, which is great. And then the overall accuracy, how well this model is working, is this number on the top left here, right?
Exactly, that's the average over all the iterations.
So it's a pretty good model, actually, the 94%.
That's pretty good, yeah.
Do you remember, actually, the time when we have been coding this whole thing?
Yeah, some time ago, that was tough.
it was pretty tough. Graham, I tell you, I think that's years ago. But this whole cross-validation
was one of the first things we built.
It was actually, yeah, really, besides a couple of machine learning methods, one of the first things.
Oh, you mean instead of using the GUI you're showing me here, building this whole thing out using code?
Well, yeah, we needed to program this because otherwise you could use it in as part of the graphical interface.
Of course.
And actually, I just changed back here to the process. So if you pick this one here, and you see all the different functionality, like the number of validations, which is really the number of different test data sets you use. So all those different parameters, the sampling type, that's so much work because you need all those different settings. Problem is really, we need to make all this work, and coding is really like a fight. It's a hard time.
There are so many rules.
Yeah, right. It's like a fight, coding. Rules.
Gentlemen, welcome to Code Club. The first rule of Code Club is you do not talk about Code Club. Second rule of Code Club, you do not talk about Code Club. Third rule of Code Club, if someone checks in, breaks a test, and goes for coffee, the hack is over. Fourth rule, only 2 keys to a join. Fifth rule, 1 line at a time, fellas. Sixth rule, no suits, no ties. Seventh rule, debugging will go on as long as it has to. soon. And the eighth and final rule.
What?
If this is your first night at Code Club, you have to code.
So that was also a fun time all the other.
It was, of course it was fun.
Yeah, well, for us.
I guess it was not for everyone.
No, it's actually, I'm happy that other people can actually just use that one here. Anyway, I would say that's what we can say about cross-validation and how this looks in practice. It's actually pretty nice if you see this, if you see the separation between training and test data. So you can see the distribution, you can have a look into every single example to figure out where like the predictive model is spot on and where it's wrong. So you see the overview table, Simon just described, but overall it's really a technique everybody should know to estimate the performance accuracy of a model. So try it out.
Cool. And this has been your 5 minutes with Ingo.
Data scientist number 7.